Hi friends, welcome to Wonder Trees. Remember, it's your channel. Don't forget to subscribe and touch the bell icon to get the alerts. Here, before we begin the video of how to treat the box in our gardens, let us find what I am viewing in my garden from flowers. I will write to share with you. So those were the roses. Then this is my desert rose. These are techno. And this is and now this is clitoria, a plant believed to be a good luck plant. If you get a chance, you must grow this flower. This gives you a beautiful starry look almost every morning throughout the year. It's a beautiful vine. This is my genia. Just beginning in this winter, this is trumpet. No, sorry. This is yes, trumpet vines. These are I have converted into bushes. Almost they can be vines. And that was a plumeria. This is my hibiscus. And these are the roses. And these are the small flowers. I do not know the name. Please, anybody knows the name, should write it to me in my comment box below. Thanks for watching. Please be with me. While moving in the garden, I came across these bad things in my garden. I was shocked to see such a huge number of caterpillar kids in my garden. One of my bonsai trees of almond, these big leaves have been completely almost eaten out by these caterpillar kids. They are so dangerous that you cannot imagine. You see this size of the leaf and they have eaten out within a very short time. In just overnight they can eat out two leaves, to your astonishment. And if you don't be careless about throwing them, about disposing them, because you see here, if you throw them just in your garden, they will never forget your garden and they will run, they will find out obstinately their ways in a queue to your plants. And even one or two, if they survive, they can kill, they can destroy, they can smash your whole garden within no time in this winter season. So here are some ways I will be telling about the other box I see in my garden. If you see these box, these caterpillars, it is always wise not to go for any treatment to them and to simply dispose them such that they cannot come back. Be careful, even one or two can kill your entire garden. So let us see other box. Here is my beautiful hibiscus attacked with box. They have killed. And you see the ants. The box are the food for the ants. So they come to eat them up and simultaneously they eat up your small portions of your plant. You see these leaves. The yellow, small yellow leaf is a complete leaf which has not been allowed to grow. You see this one also, this has not allowed to grow by the ants. They almost kill the soft portions along with the box and they start living there. You should remove them. The first step is to remove them. Then let us locate where the box are really are. They are so intelligent, so obstinate. They find out places where you cannot find them easily. Here I am showing you how they are hiding themselves here in between the leaves at the juncture of their growth. You see the white portions, the white spots, they are the balls. And the same box here are on my chrysanthemum. If you neglect them, only few days, they can kill up, they can destroy your entire plant. Here the white spot is a bug, probably mealybug. But for any bug, any type of insect, I'm going to tell you about a trick, a simple treatment for the bugs in order to get good flowers and get your plants healthy. Here at the top you are seeing two spots. Those are also bugs. Here you can see more clearly bugs sticking to the stick just at the nodes. Here is kaner, another plant which has been also attacked. Here is an chrysanthemum. Again, you can see the ants here. The ants are trying to kill the bugs, but they fall in love with killing the soft petals, some flowers, and soft leaves also. So in that case, we shouldn't take time to destroy them. As I see them now, it is a shocking scene for me. Now I am going to find out a old spray bottle in my storeroom or in my waist. Yes, I have got now. This is a spray of a medicine. Now I will use it as a sprayer because I need a little amount of treatment. So a little spray will manage. And the trick is your hand wash. Take few drops only. Take any hand wash because they are soft and they are smelly and they are very sticky. You see here I am putting few drops. Yes, yes, yes. It's sufficient for the need today. Then I will add some water to the bottle. Then I will fit the cap to it. Keep it closely tight and shake it well before I use, because they are so sticky that it will take time to dissolve completely in the water we have taken. After the solution is ready, now we are going to spray the same liquid to our affected plants and kill those bugs and keep the plants healthy. Now let us start it from my hibiscus. Here at the top we are seeing we have cleared those dead flowers and buds. Now we are spraying at the top where it is needed. Please check if at any other point the bugs are there. They can be treated with this simple trick of hand wash solution. You can see the movement of the ants. They are going away from the place and trying to find out some way to go out. Spray the places where you have seen, you have located the bugs. Then the chrysanthemum, we have to locate the exact points where the bugs are. And we'll just repeat the same phenomenon. We'll spray the liquid over the leaves so that it is made completely wet and more of the spray is sprayed over the box. As the box here we are seeing clearly, we should spray over them so that they will die. And there will be no coming back of those bugs. If you spray regularly, every day for a couple of days or say 3 days, then there will be full stop for their coming back. This is a simple trick to keep the box away from your garden and to save your plants. Now you see the ants, they have come and accumulated over the tip of the leaf, and they will find out their way if you don't disturb them. It is wise, of course, to make them away physically. So this is the simple trick how to treat your box in your garden and keep your plants healthy. If you like, please subscribe and touch the bell icon. Thanks for watching. Please tell me the name of this plant in the comment box below.